He gets Ezreal stolen away, as you so well predicted very well.
Paris.
But then he locks in a stationary AD carry against
top with red buff, and this spells very, very dangerous things for Darshan. Gonna try and get out.
FaZe dive to Karsa, trying to gain a little bit of ground, and the lanes once again in favor.
Wait, Karsa!
There it is! Karsa flashes forward, he stays alive! It's not enough damage from the seems like there's been a different focus on the lane here for CLG. They'd usually have a ward out, focusing on the heals, focusing on keeping Afro alive! Wolf bites down! Karsa gets another kill for the flash walls. That's gonna be another one for Karsa coming out of the jungle.
Top laner sense. He knows that there's a very dangerous Kindred on the map.
Now he does. What's he gonna do about it,
level
though?
Level 6, he doesn't want to go back the other
way! Knowing is only half the battle, Crepo!
There for CounterLogic Gaming to utilize.
Crescendo!
Oh, the flash crescendo! It puts Maple in a bad spot, but he actually may be able to live before his tier, till his team gets here, I should say. Lamb's respite goes down. Maple's alive, and they have just juked a huge initiation from CounterLogic Gaming.
Roll potential.
And I feel like they don't need to play. Oh, okay.
Backing out, it's gonna be the summoner heal. Lamb's respite still up. There's that Huhi teleport he was looking to make before. They're gonna have Karsa onto the turret. He drops it for the gold, knowing this isn't gonna be a good end for him. That Rift Herald will be down now.
Meanwhile, topside, Darshan is trading while Maple is
pretty happy with this trade. Definitely Flash was stepping out of bounds, because they could have taken that push a lot slower here. We have more action in the top lane, though.
Ooh, Darshan was getting quite a bit of love. No.
Nope. Trying to help out, but they're just going for the Dragon. CLG trying to make a play.
The 3v1 by MMD more than once throughout this series from Game 2 to Game 3. Chain of Corruption goes out. He flashed forward. Brings that to the team. It looks like Afro is going to go down. One last shot. That was from Karsa. Now he gets another one. Huhi will drop NL, but in the fight, Sixsay looking to make the last hit. So is Karsa. He flies forward. Sixsay heals up, and he's going to keep himself alive. Actually, the heal, sorry, from Lamb's respite.
Can Sixsay rejoin this? Darshan's trying to fight 3v1. Sixsay's on the outside.
Darshan does. Looks like he's a little too far in from the poke. From Sixsay to matter that.
Maple can hold his own very well with these Azir turrets in the mid.
MMD on the bottom side making a play while Smithy finishes off this turret. Let's see.
Aframu taken down without any rebuttal. The crescendo did go out there as well. Once again, dodged by the flash. Straight down the mid lane with Azir there. They might be able to lock this down. Darshan's in with a parallel convergence onto Karsa.
Oh, so
close. Lamb's respite goes down. Who's the first kill and who gets out alive? Sword Art's not even going to wait for the heal. Karsa gets a bit of it and they are going to back off.
They had to make that defense and use the flash crescendo. Oh my goodness, they caught it out.
Huge catch. Who he should stay alive in that situation. Maple kill still goes over the wall. He's gonna try to hit this up, but he may have just lost himself to Sixsay and the rest of the team. McSmithy and the rest happy to pick this one up. Now two down for Flash Wolves. Should be a mid turret for CounterLogic Gaming and an opening they have been looking for.
This is exactly
for
what CLG want. Getting a little bit scrappy, trading kills back and forth, trying to even it up, but now
with the fight's onto McSmithy, back towards the turret. Everybody's in a safe spot here, but Darshan has got himself pretty deep with Chrono Break still up. Looks to get himself out. No walls to be stunned by this time, so he can get that HP there, but is forced to flash away from Karsa. True Shot Barrage is enough to finish down Karsa. Three still down, or three. Kind of waited out, staring into the white of Flash Wolf's eyes.
Whoa, Maple goes deep.
The exhaust onto Huhi. They can start to use this against Flash Wolves now. Lamb's respite down and they're forced out of it immediately. Aframu takes the chance right away. And now to flash over the wall. They're on his Sword Art now, clearing him out. And CLG's been biding their time for just these
the fights. Key ultimate.
Simply nothing they could do about it because Maple made a crucial mistake.
Oh, the Baron getting low, and Flash Wolves would have to make some crazy plays to get in there. CLG takes so much back of this. Flash Wolves, it looked like they've
been. Now CLG gets to play on the side of Flash Wolves after being pushed onto their home court for the majority of the game. Darshan finding trouble here, but pressure from CLG in the top lane with quite a few resources here by Flash Wolves in the bot. A turret has gone down now in favor of CLG, and Darshan is ready to fall for his team.
And this is the play.
Well passed. Uh-oh, here we go.
Brutal on each other.
Oh, they re-engage.
Oh, where's the respite? It's not happening this time. That's the nail in the coffin for CounterLogic Gaming. MMD right through the uprights, and nobody's going to get knocked back home. A minute on Dragon coming up, but it looks like they're going to be taking inhibitors before that's even an option.
6A tried to 2v1
very,
tower
very
dive.
Low, almost burns down. He's going to limp away from the fight. Darshan's on the backside already. Snipe. That's the True Shot Barrage.
Gets a taste himself.
Yeah, the combo just annihilates. Re-engage potential of that crescendo is definitely there. Flash Wolves desperately trying to force these fights. MMD going down. They simply can't withstand this late game pressure from Counter-Logic Gaming.
The spike couldn't have happened at a better time. CLG knew they could continue to take hold, strangled down on Flash Wolves' composition. Coming big here. Uhi back onto Karsa. That's the one they need. It brings away, or takes away the 50-50. Lamb's Respite goes down. They're now onto the canal. He gets cleansed out. And now Flash Wolves is trying to get out of this fight. MMD tries to get away. Collateral damage picks him up as Counter-Logic Gaming is just slowly choosing their next target with precision. And now it's going to be onto Sword Art. Nothing's going to save him here from Darshan. Or at least he's not going to get to the Fountain. And CLG is going to be looking for Nexus turrets here. A few for the kills. A few for the win, and they don't have much more before they finalize the game. Coming up huge on this one, Counter-Logic Gaming stop the bleeding 20 minutes in and are able to pull themselves back into the lead.
Poise for CLG when facing the deficit and calmly executing the team fights over and over again.
GGs are out. Counter